Hey guys, welcome back. This time I wanted to show off my Incredible Hulk Volume 2 collection. I've been recently sorting them and putting them up in a Comic Collector Live, so I thought it would be interesting to show them off. And I'm not gonna go through each book individually, or I will show every book, but I don't want to comment too much because it's a lot of books, so I'm just gonna show them off. So the first book you can see here is the facsimile edition that was recently released of Hulk 181. As you can imagine, I can't afford this book because it's been very expensive for a lot of years now. So this is the lowest numbering Hulk book I have. Then we come to Hulk 193 from 1974, which has Doc Samson on the cover. Next up is Hulk 221 with the Stingray cover from 1977. Then we come to the True Believers reprint from recently, which is, I think, 235. They never put the original numbering on the cover, and this is the first appearance of Quasar, so it's more Quasar-related on the cover, although he's not shown on the cover. Then we have Hulk 241 from 1979. Then 245 from 1979. Also, as you can see, most of these books are a little bit banged up. They're rather mid-grade condition. And this is issue 248 with an appearance of the Gardener on the cover. A very nice cover also. Then we have issue 251 with a 3D Man appearance on the cover. Then we have 252, where he's fighting the changelings on the cover. And there's 253 with another appearance of Doc Samson on the cover. Here we have 258 with the Soviet super soldiers on the cover, as you can read. Then we have 259 from 1981. Then there's issue number 260, where he fights Major Glenn Talbot. 261, where he fights the Absorbing Man. 262. 264. Then we have 265, where he goes up against the Rangers. This is 266, where he fights the Evolutionary. 267 from 1981. 268 from 1981. This is issue 269, where he fights the Hulk Hunters. And then we come to the probably most expensive Hulk book in my collection. That's why I decided to put it in a top loader. This is 271 with the first appearance of Rocket Raccoon, which has due to the Guardians of the Galaxy movie, a very sought after book. Then we have 273 and 282 with a She-Hulk appearance. Then next up is issue 286 from 1983, issue 287 from 1983. Here we have issue 290, where he fights MODOK and MODEM on the cover. Here we have issue 291, which is the issue where Thunderbolt Ross commits suicide, or tries to commit suicide, I'm not exactly sure. Here's issue 292, with a Dragon Man appearance on the cover. Issue 293, with a Fantastic Four appearance on the cover. A nice painted cover on issue 294, which looks pretty nice. Then we have issue 295, where he fights the Boomerang. Issue 296, where he fights Rom, or Rom has a guest appearance in the book. Issue 297. Issue 298, where he fights Nightmare. Issue 299, where he battles against Doctor Strange. Then the anniversary issue 300, where he fights the Avengers. Issue 301, with a nice Bill Sienkiewicz cover. Issue 302, with a nice early Mike Mignola cover. Issue 303. Issue 304, with another early Mike Mignola cover. Very different from the art style he has nowadays. Another Mike Mignola cover on issue 305. And again a Mike Mignola cover on issue 306. Also a Mike Mignola cover on issue 307, which looks pretty cool. Then we have issue 308, which is also a Mike Mignola cover. So he did a bunch of covers at that time for the Hulk book. So this is also a Mike Mignola cover, issue 309. Here we have issue 310 with a cover by Brad Blevins. Another Mike Mignola cover, issue 311. Here's, let me put those books aside now before they start to slide off. So here we have issue 312 with another Mike Mignola cover. Issue 313 with a Mike Mignola cover. And issue 314, where he fights MODOK, the Leader, Abomination, the Juggernaut, and Rhino. Then we have issue 315, where the Hulk and Banner gets split into two entities by Doc Samson, as far as I can remember. Issue 316, where the Hulk fights the Avengers again. Issue 317. Issue 318, with another appearance of Doc Samson. Issue 319, where he tried to marry Thunderbolt Ross's daughter. 320, with another Doc Samson appearance on the cover. 321, another Avengers fight scene on the cover. 322, with another appearance of the Avengers. 323, with the Vision on the cover. Then we have 324, with the return of the Grey Hulk. I've also got the True Believers issue of this. I don't know why I ordered it, but it was only $1. These are very cheap. Then we have the anniversary issue, Marvel 25th anniversary, with the cover, with the face covers, number 325. Then we have 326, 327, where he fights Zax. 328, 331, and 332. Then we have issue 333. I've also got a reprint from 1993 of this book. So let's take those to the side and pick up the next stack. Then we have issue 334, issue 335, issue 336, Where He Fights X Factor, issue 337, where he fights with X Factor, issue 338, issue 339, and the famous issue 340 with the nice McFarlane Wolverine cover, which is very sought after. Issue 341 with another McFarlane cover, and I think this was also the time where he did the interiors on the book. Issue 342 with a nice leader cover, also drawn by McFarlane. Issue 343, which was also a cover by Todd McFarlane. Issue 344, another McFarlane cover. Issue 345, with a nice Todd McFarlane cover. Issue 346, which is a cover collaboration of Eric Larson and Todd McFarlane. Issue 347. Issue 349, issue 354, issue 355, and issue 358. So, get the next stack. So here we have issue 359, where he fights the Abomination with Wolverine and the Thing, as you can see. Issue 360 with another Nightmare story. Issue 361 where he fights Iron Man, and this is the Mr. Fix-It timeline, I think. Issue 362 with the Werewolf by Night crossover. Issue 363, where he fights the Grey Gargoyle. Issue 364, the Walt Simonson cover. Issue 365, where he fights the Female Thing, and it's also a nice Walt Simonson cover. Issue 366, where he fights the Leader, also Walt Simonson cover. Another Walt Simonson cover, issue 367, where he fights the Madman. Issue 369, where he goes up against Freedom Force. So let's take those to the side. Issue 370, where he fights the Nightmare, and it's a sort of team up with the original Defenders, with Namor and Doctor Strange. The first appearance of the Dark Hulk in issue 371 with Strange and Namor. Issue 372. Issue 373 with Betty Ross on the cover. Issue 377, issue 378, as you can see, a Christmas related story where he fights Santa Claus. Issue 379 with a nice Dae Kyon cover. Issue 380 with an appearance of Dr. Samson, or Doc Samson. Issue 381, I think this is where he joins the Pantheon. Issue 382. Issue 383 was the Abomination. Issue 384. issue 385, issue 386, issue 387, issue 388 against Speed Freak, issue 389 with a nice Man Thing cover, issue 390, another nice Daekyon cover, issue 391 versus the new X Factor, issue 392, another crossover with the new X Factor, or new at that time. Then we have issue 393. This is the second printing, I think, with the silver cover. And here's the green foil first printing. Issue 394. Issue 393 with a nice Punisher appearance on the cover, one of my favorite Hulk covers, also drawn by Dale Keown. Issue 396, another Punisher crossover. Issue 397, Hulk versus the UFOs. Issue 398, Ghost of the Past versus the Leader. Issue 399. Then we get to the first printing of issue 400, which has a nice foil gimmick cover. A lot of people hate those. I honestly really like those covers. I think they look nice. I've also got the second printing with a white background of issue 400. Here's issue 401, where Hulk defeats, I think, Ironclad is his name. Here's issue 402. 403, where he fights several bad guys, including Doc Ock and the Juggernaut, as you can see. Issue 405, where Hulk teams up with Juggernaut versus the Avengers for some reason. Can't remember really. It's been a long time since I read most of those, and I read the German adaptions of those. So here we have issue 405, issue 406 versus Doc Samson again and Captain America. So let's take those books to another side and bring up the next box. So then we have issue 407, issue 408, issue 409 with a guest appearance of Motormouth and Killpower, which were Marvel UK characters that they tried to promote at that time. Issue 410 with a guest appearance of Nick Fury. Put more of the books here. Issue 411, another appearance of Nick Fury. Issue 412 with a She-Hulk guest appearance. Issue 413. Issue 414 with a guest appearance of Silver Surfer. Issue 415 with a guest appearance of the Starjammers. Issue 416 Issue 417 with a guest appearance of the Avengers. Issue 418, the gatefold cover with the marriage of Rick Jones and I can't remember her name right now. Issue 419, Hulk vs. Tale of the Tamed, Sword of Skrull, or not a Sword of Skrull. Issue 420, the famous AIDS issue, where a friend of the Hulk dies from AIDS. Issue 421. Issue 422. Issue 423, with the guest appearance of Hela, or Hela, however you want to pronounce it. Issue 424. And issue 425, with another very gimmicky, nice hologram cover. I think this looks really awesome. Issue 426. Issue 427, with another appearance of Man-Thing, also a very nice cover. Issue 428, another appearance, guest appearance of Man-Thing. Issue 429. Issue 430. Here we have issue 431 with an appearance of Abomination. Issue 432 with another appearance of Abomination. So let's put those to the side. Then we have issue 433, another guest appearance of the Punisher. Issue 434, I think this is supposed to be the funeral of Nick Fury. Issue 435, with a guest appearance of Rhino. Issue 436, very nice Ghost of the Future sideways cover with the Maestro on the cover. Issue 437, with Major Glenn Talbot on the cover. Issue 438, issue 439 with Leader and Maestro on the cover. Issue 440 with Thor on the cover. Issue 441, nice Pulp Fiction reference with She-Hulk on the cover. Issue 424. Issue 443. Issue 444, part of the Onslaught crossover. Issue 445, another Onslaught crossover. Issue 446, I think at this point the Hulk was again separated from Banner. Issue 447, and a variant cover of issue 447. By Mike Deodato Jr., or both covers are by Mike Deodato Jr. Variant covers at that time were very rare and few. Issue 448. Issue 449, which is the first appearance of the Thunderbolts. And issue 450, another double-sized anniversary issue. Then we have issue 451, issue 452, issue 453, all Mike Deodato covers, issue 454 with an appearance of Wolverine on the cover and Kesar on the insides, issue 455 with a guest appearance of the X-Men. Issue 456, where Apocalypse turns Hulk into one of his acolytes. One of his horsemen, I'm sorry. Issue 457, Hulk versus Juggernaut. nice Adam Kubert cover. Issue 458, Hulk vs. Mr. Hyde. Issue 459. Issue 460, which marked the return of Bruce Banner. Issue 461, I think this is where he merged again with the Hulk after he came back from the Heroes Return universe. Issue 462. Issue 463. Issue 464 versus the Silver Surfer. And now we're coming to the final 10 issues in this run. 465 with a guest appearance of Mr. Fantastic, as you can see. Issue 466, another really nice Adam Kubert cover. Issue 467. Issue 468. Issue 469 versus the Adaptoid, I think the character was called Super Adaptoid. It's right on the cover. Issue 407. Versus the Circus of Crime. Issue 471. Issue 472. Issue 473 with a guest appearance of the Watcher. And issue 474, which was the final book in this volume 2 series. After this, it was relaunched as Hulk again and then turned into Incredible Hulk volume 3. I will probably do a video with those books in the future at some point, but for right now that's it. I hope you enjoyed seeing my Hulk Incredible Hulk volume 2 collection, and maybe till next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.